ako po ay natutuwa na meron na pong darating ngayong Pebrero na mga vaccine.
Even before the actual rollout of the country's COVID-19 immunization program, the government says it has secured enough vaccines to inoculate all 70 million adult Filipinos. Officials say the expected total supply as of February 16 is at least 140 million doses in 2021. But getting those jabs into the arms of every adult Filipino is a huge, challenging undertaking.
For us, it's more complicated, I would say, kasi we are an archipelago with several islands. In other countries, you just need to bring them to the capital, tapos sa truck na lang, diba? And those trucks they have fridges. It's more challenging for a country like us. You bring it to Manila, you have to bring it again to the different islands, right? Regions.
Vaccines are sensitive biological products. Some are sensitive to heat, some to freezing, and others to light. It must be kept in a temperature-controlled setup during transportation from the manufacturing facility to the vaccination site in an environment that is called a vaccine cold chain.
These vaccine chains are very complex. Supply chains can actually make or break your vaccination efforts because if these vaccines are in a temperature that can destroy whatever is in the vaccine, then hindi na siya gagana or posibleng gagana, pero yung efficacy niya is not as good as we expect.
The government's portfolio has 7 vaccine brands which have different efficacy rates and require different cold chains. Pfizer vaccines must be kept at minus 70 degrees Celsius, Moderna at minus 20 degrees Celsius, and the rest refrigerated between 2 and 8 degrees Celsius. Having the highest efficacy rates, Pfizer and Moderna jabs pose the biggest challenge.
Yung mRNA kasi, it's very sensitive to changes in pH and temperature. Mas mabilis talaga ito ma-disintegrate or masira.
Ang isa pong malaking challenge for vaccines that need ultra-cold freezers, hindi po ganong kadami ang mga lugar na meron nito. Marami pong power ang kailangan ng refrigerator, lalo na po ang freezers, at lalong-lalo na po ang ultra-cold freezers. Pwedeng may mga lugar na may unstable ang electric supply, kaya po kailangan natin ang mga UPS or uninterrupted power supply.
Under the National Vaccine Deployment Plan, RITM will serve as the centralized hub for vaccines that need to be stored at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius and minus 20 degrees Celsius. From RITM, the vaccines will be delivered to regional warehouses and DOH health centers for distribution to LGUs, which will allocate the vaccines.
Yung mga 2 to 8 na mga nabili po, ito po ang pwede natin i-deploy sa mga power plants dahil hindi po ito nangangailangan ng news na cold chain.
Sanica says it is not practical to distribute the vaccines to all health centers since not all areas have cold storage facilities.
Ang pwede lang mangyari, yung mga capital cities, maybe dun ang resources and you bring the people there instead of bringing the vaccines to the people.
According to the DOH, BARM and 22 select provinces and cities have no cold storage facilities.
Nagkaroon na po tayo ng tinatawag nating logistic workshop noong December 16. At nakita po natin talaga na meron tayo pong kakayahan para sa mga cold chain for 2 to 8. Hanggang ano po tayo, hanggang regional po yan. Kayang-kaya po lang i-handle ang 2 to 8 dahil kasi po yung mga traditional vaccine.
Jabs that require ultra-cold storage will go first to rented private warehouses before deployment to health facilities. Once taken out of the ultra-cold storage, the Pfizer vaccine can be stored for only 5 days in 2 to 8 degrees Celsius fridges. Moderna says its vaccine can remain stable in a standard home or medical fridge for up to 30 days and in minus 20 degrees Celsius for 6 months. Janssen Pharma, on the other hand, says its vaccine can remain stable for at least 2 years in minus 20 degrees Celsius and at least 3 months in 2 to 8 degrees Celsius storage.
Ito po ang Moderna at saka yung Pfizer. Deploy po natin po yan dito po sa Manila at saka po dito sa Cebu at saka dito sa Davao. Ituturo po natin kagad dyan. Uunahin po natin yung 4 na referral hospitals natin dito sa Metro Manila. Itong PGH, yung Philippine General Hospital, Lung Center, itong East Avenue at saka yung Tala Hospital dito sa Caloocan City.
As of December 31 last year, the cold storage facility of RITM is almost full. Only 4% of its 2 to 8 degrees Celsius fridges are free, while almost 84% of its minus 15 and minus 25 degrees Celsius freezers are occupied.
Yung ibang mga COVID vaccines, kailangan multiple doses, kailangan may storage space for subsequent doses, at hindi dapat nito ma-displace ang storage space ng mga bakuna na kasama sa ating National Immunization Program. Kasi priority rin po naman natin yon.
To address the cold storage facility concerns, the Health Department is negotiating with at least 16 third-party logistics providers, including Zulig Pharma and Unilab Philippines.
It's not enough to come up with a vaccine supply chain and design. I think everyone involved in the vaccination initiative needs to know what the plans are so that they can act accordingly.